Sri Lanka's most powerful news brand.
One story we have been very closely monitoring is the situation pertaining to Sri Lankan Airlines. Yesterday we showed you how the incompetence of the authorities of the previous government and the incompetence of the government officials in the present government who were appointed to look into this problem and to create a solution, to provide a solution to the problem, have failed in doing so, and this has resulted in the massive losses at Sri Lankan Airlines. Now, we also have to keep in mind that Sri Lankan Airlines is simply running on loan after loan. They are obtaining loans to salvage the situation at Sri Lankan Airlines. This situation was raised at the SLFP meeting that was held, and here's what happened.
Sri Lankan Airlines has suffered billions in losses. Now the board of directors is getting ready to resign. Will you allow them to wash their hands of the debt they created?
The president is the person who revealed all this to the nation. He is the one who said that we will take immediate action on it. I believe that everything you have just said will be covered through these investigations. The responsible persons have been given instructions. We need to start a revolution when the issue arises.
A commission will be appointed and legal action will be initiated. No matter how they hope to escape, they won't be able to escape the law and the international law.
In the inability of these officials when it comes to salvaging what has happened to the national carrier is indeed a problem that every one of us has to sit and think. But two people or two parties, two segments have been constantly talking about the situation pertaining to our national carrier. One being the media, of course, and the other being the trade unions that are involved at the Sri Lankan Airlines. We spoke to the Nidhas Sevaka Sangame of the Sri Lankan Airlines to get their view on things. This is what they had to say.
Sri Lankan Guan Samagama.
The committee report on the restructuring of Sri Lankan Airlines was handed over to the government on the 20th of last month. It has been 2 weeks, but the government is yet to take steps to discuss this with the trade unions. What we need to state is that we should take into consideration the recommendations of the Presidential Commission before we discuss the restructuring process. We also need to reiterate that the Prime Minister should be kept away from the administration of the airline because there are allegations against him with regard to the bond scam. The President himself said that the Prime Minister has done something he should have not, so he no longer has to play on this pitch.
It is a common saying that knowledge is experience. Now, what happened to all the experience when it came to the decision making with regard to Sri Lankan Airlines? The officials at Sri Lankan Airlines have said that they have a last option, and that is the closure of our national carrier. That means that we will no longer have a national carrier in Sri Lanka, the ambassador of our country, as some call it. Is this the only option, or is there another option? We met a Sri Lankan official who had been working overseas to resurrect a company, who had been in a situation like that, a different national airline of a different country. We spoke to Mr. Vasanta Kumara Siri. He had been the CEO of an international airline. This is what he had to say.
This airline operates from sunrise to sunset because most of the outports don't have the lights. The airline ran into losses for the last 32 years actually. I took over the position as a CEO in 2006 and I was the CEO until 2013. We recovered within 3 years. To make it possible, there were a lot of supporting activities. Those were my Prime Minister as well as the ministers, subsequent ministers, two Prime Ministers and two ministers, three ministers. They all supported the board and myself as the management CEO, and they allowed us to operate this airline, and also he asked me to maintain the highest level of governance, and we maintained that. And I had a very commercially savvy board, and the board supported me, as well as I created a team, supporting team together, the executive management team as well as all the staff, and I conducted a lot of training to all the staff, from the cleaner to the most senior manager, including myself, was trained on a certain thing, that is, get rid of the complacency and bring urgency. The complacency can destroy any large organization. We carried out the job by example. So I behaved in exemplary manner, and then press followed. So that support brought it there. And we paid dividends to the government. We paid very good bonuses. And we dealt with all the four unions in a very harmonious manner. And we resolved all their outstanding arrears issues for 10 or 15 years. And also, I'm very happy to say, the pilot body, with a marginal salary increase, we negotiated to increase their productivity by 40%. Because everybody was made to understand rescuing this airline is everyone's responsibility.